Here at Zen Bauer on the judges' stand on this beautiful evening here in Bedford, Pennsylvania. We sure welcome everyone on this great night of racing as the stars and cars get ready to take on the big half mile. On the pre-race show, we like to get a little bit more up close and personal with the movers and shakers in the world of racing. So tonight, we welcome Austin Berry, Juniata County's first and finest, well, you are now since Mitch Hack is retired.
Yeah, thank you. I appreciate it. Nice to be here.
Hey, Austin. You guys have put together a pretty nice little race team, and I know everybody up in Mifflin Town, Fort Roll, you know each other, you know, really get along great, and it just, I've been following you, and you really put together some nice runs over the years.
I appreciate it. Thank you, Jody. You know how it goes. You did this for a while. It's taken my dad and all of us, my brother, my wife, my mom, just everything working and working and working to get where we're at. Unfortunately, it's taken 6 to 7 years to get here, but I'm finally starting to come together.
Finishing seventh there in this heat race. One spot out of making it into the feature. Start second in the B main. Hopefully we can get in.
We'll be right back.
just got back to the shop and we got to wash everything up for Port Royal tomorrow.
Off 10th from Mifflin and the Tire Mart Pros of Harrisburg, Juniata Veterinary Clinic, Berwick Siding and Seamless Gutters, SRI Performance 86 of Austin Berry.
So after fighting it the last three nights, or two nights I guess, all night Friday night at Bedford, and then qualifying tonight, we finally got the motor running right. So the heat race, with the motor running right, we didn't tighten the car up enough, so we weren't quite where we needed to be there. We were too free. We're still able to go 10th to 8th. We were probably fast enough to run 6th and transfer, but didn't quite get it. So we adjusted on the car a little bit more. We're going to roll off 5th here for this B main. We're taking the top 6, so hopefully move forward, get a couple cars on the pass in the feature though.
Top 6 finishers moving on into tonight's 4,000 win feature event. See who these drivers are going to be as Matt Cosner and Chad Julius bring them down. Here we go, we're underway.
Cosner with good start. He'll lead him into turn one as Lathrop look down to the inside, won't be able to make the pass as Wilson battles with Julius for that third spot. Austin Berry charging down the backstretch.
Look at the 86. Yes, Austin Berry really found some bite. The bottom side of turn two, pull alongside Chad Julius. Got Tiffins in the three just in front of him. That's going to be a three-car battle for the third spot.
Julius got in a little too hot there in one, and the 86 lost to Berry, able to capitalize on the bottom side, move him into the fourth spot. Now going to try in to reel in that third place spot of Tim Wilson.
Still didn't run quite right, but I think we got our fuel pressure a little bit too high. We had a porcelain crack on one spark plug. But the car was fast. We went fifth to third. We were definitely faster than the guys that won it and run second. So it's a lot better. We're getting there. Get the motor to run full song, full, you know, completely healthy. Did pretty good. Tweaked on the car a little bit. Bolted some new old rubber on for starting 21st. And see what happens. If we can make it close to a top 10, that'll make it a successful night from what started out pretty crappy. So, see what happens.
it's still not completely right. I mean, it's running good, but it's not.
What's fuel pressure?
Like 8 pound, 7.5.
Seven and a half,
8 pound. I mean, it ran pretty strong there, but like something just doesn't seem quite right yet.
I don't know what else to do.
Good temp, 210. Well, you can tell the car was digging. The old temp was about 310.
Really?
But I will say, even on those new tires, I can haul this one.